हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन। माय सेल्फ नमिता श्रीवास्तव वेलकम यू ऑल इन ऑनलाइन क्लास। चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अनदर चैप्टर ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर, दैट इज़ अ पोएम, लेसन 8 इन द बाजार्स ऑफ हैदराबाद, विच इज़ कंपोज्ड बाय सरोजनी नायडू। इन दिस पोएम, इन द बाजार्स ऑफ हैदराबाद, विच इज़ in the forms of questions and answers. The poetess visits the sellers and asks the questions what they are selling. They tell to her about their products. So let's discuss about the poem and the poetess. This poem describes the various stalls in the bazaars of Hyderabad. The poem consists of questions and answers. Born with Bengali roots to an intellectually gifted parents, Sarojini Naidu had the opportunity to receive good education both in India and in England. She wrote many touching poems, winning hearts from readers in India and overseas. Sarojini Naidu, the Nightingale of India, was a patriot and a freedom fighter. But her first love was poetry. When she started writing poetry, she imitated English poets. Soon, however, she began to write about Indian themes. She played an important part in the social and cultural life of Hyderabad. For many years, many of her popular poems centered around the rustic simplicity, beauty, and diversity of Indian rural life. She contributed in the freedom struggle of India. She was the president of Indian National Congress and the first woman governor of India. So, let's start the poem. What do you sell, O merchants? Richly your wares are displayed. Turbans of crimson and silver, tunics of purple brocade, mirrors with panels of amber, daggers with handles of jade. In the first stanza, the poet meets some merchants, seeing their goods which are richly displayed, asks them what they are selling. The merchants reply that they are selling deep red and silver colored turbans, purple garments with silver and gold threading, mirrors with amber, a precious resin used for decoration, and also daggers whose handle are made of green stone. It is a precious stone, jade. In the very first stanza, it becomes clear that the poet is trying to tell the readers how rich India is. Now, second stanza. What do you wake, O vendors? Saffron and lentil and rice. What do you grind, O maidens? Sandalwood, henna and spice. What do you call, O peddlers? Jasmine and ivory dice. Next, the poet goes to vendors and asks them what they are weighing on the scale. They reply that saffron, very precious ingredients, pulses and rice. Next, she asks the maidens what they are grinding. The maidens reply that they are grinding sandalwood, henna and spices. She meets salesmen and asks them what they are calling for selling. They reply that they are selling chessmen and ivory dice, made up of ivory, a precious substance for chess game. Now, what do you make, O goldsmiths? Wristlet and anklet and ring. Bells for the feet of blue pigeons, frail as a dragonfly's wing. Girdles of gold for the dancers, scabbards of gold for the king. Now the poet meets goldsmiths and asks them what they are making. They reply that they are making ornaments for wrist and ankles and also rings. They continue saying that they are making bells for the feet of blue pigeons. These bells are as weak and delicate as a wing of a dragonfly. They are also making belts of gold for the dancers, swords and daggers made up of gold for the king. These lines depict how rich the Indians are. What do you cry, O a fruit man? Citron, pomegranate and plum. What do you play, O musicians? Sitar, sarangi and drum. What do you chant, O magicians? Spells for the aeons to come. Next he meets vendors selling fruits and asks them what they are selling by crying. They reply that they are selling citron, pomegranate and plum. They all are the fruits. Now she meets musicians and asks them what they are playing. They reply sitar, sarangi and drum. All types of instruments. Next she asks magicians what they are chanting. They reply that they are chanting magic spells for aeons, a supreme deity, to help them show their magic tricks. Now this is the last stanza. What do you weave, O a flower girls, with tassels of azure and red? Chaplets to garland his bed, seeds of white blossom new gather to perfume the sleep of the dead. Now finally, where she reaches? She reaches flower girls and asks them what they are weaving with bright blue and red threads. They reply that they are weaving crowns for the brow of a bridegroom and flowers to decorate his bedroom. They are also making new seeds full of white colored flowers to fill a dead person's grave with fragrance. Thus, they are making everything from one's joy to his grief. Now, thus the poet Sarojini Naidu represents an Indian market to give us a sense of the rich Indian heritage. This poem was her protest against the European products and an appreciation of our own good. I hope you all have enjoyed the chapter. So once again, go through the chapter, keep learning, keep practicing, study well at home. That's all for this video lecture. Thank you so much.